So today we'll look at 5 best practices for organizing your code in Rust language. So first, use consistent naming conventions. Now this is very, very important because it helps make your code very readable and makes it a lot easier for other people to understand your code. For example, functions, you should use snake case, small letters for functions. Just small letters throughout while separating every word with underscores. The same thing for macros and then for variables. However, for structs, types, threads, you should name them using camel case, starting the name of every variable using capital letters. So each word in the name must start with a capital letter. Now for constants, every single thing must be a capital letter. Okay, you can then separate each of the words with underscore. Secondly, in certain cases, use enums instead of structs. Now, if you come from other languages, you probably have been using classes for everything. However, in Rust, due to the powers enums have, in many cases, you'll be better off using enums than using structs. For example, in this case, you are trying to manage colors, and here we have an enum we've defined that we call colors, color. Then we have another struct here that we defined that we named my color. But watch what the difference is here. This struct has 3 fields, red, green, and blue. So when you have an instance of this struct, you can provide U8 values for each of these fields. However, with an enum, we could achieve even more, where we can have an RGB variant of the color and also a hex variant of the color. To achieve this with struct, we would have had to add more details. In fact, looking at it this way, enum has more details packed inside it than struct, and you can see when we are using it here, while using the my color struct, we provided the values, which is the RGB values for the color as well. We said color, and then we use the double colon to access hex, which is a variant of this color. This way you can have even another variant of color. Now thirdly, organize your codes into modules. Now you can see what we did here. We have a module that we called product. Okay. Naturally, we would have created this function getSimpleProduct out here, not inside the module, and even this getVariation function, not inside a module. Declaring them inside the module encapsulates them here. Therefore, whoever we access them, we can must go through the product variants. Okay, so this way we can hide this module that we called variation inside this product's module. As an example, if you're inside a function, you can no longer call, you won't be able to call get variation function. It's not going to work because it's now private, because it's inside a module that it is private. Okay, so you can try to call get variation function from inside the main function, but it's not going to work because the module, the function is inside, is private. Okay, this way you get to hide some code and also reveal some. That will also improve security. The fourth tip, keep your modules small and focused. You can see what we did here. We have a product module and we also have an orders module. Everything that is related to order, functions, structs, and all that will be defined inside this orders module. However, for products, everything that is related to products, like this getSimpleProduct function, will be grouped inside the products module. In fact, we can also group other modules inside here, like the variation, product variations module. So keep it small and focused. That way your modules will be tightly cohesive and loosely coupled to other modules. Now the last tip is to move your modules in separate files. If you are coming from other object-oriented programming languages, you should have known this by now, where you have to group, keep all your classes in different modules. In Rust, you are advised to keep your modules in different files. For example, you can see here that we have a module for orders, where we will define everything related to orders. We have another module for products. Here, we create like functions that are related to products, and even structs, and even other modules as well. You can also have submodules that we define in other files, like funding, where we created functions that are related to fundings and also trackings. where we have functions that are related to other trackings. So that's it guys, always have all these 5 points in mind and you'll be able to write consistent and durable code. Make sure to like the video and subscribe so that you get notified when we release new videos.